It's another season of hard-hitting Quinnipiac ice hockey and red-hot basketball, side-by-side in one of college sports' most amazing venues for fans. Check the schedule and get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com.
So getting an education and playing NCAA rather than go north to Canada. And we're also trying to market and promote and better expose our sport across the country.
How much of a challenge is that? I know Junior A hockey really dangles the carrot out to try and get these kids. How tough is it to try and get them to a university?
It's challenging for our coaches. I mean, they have some pretty rigorous NCAA regulations that they have to live by. The major junior programs don't have the restraints that our coaches have, but we have a great product to sell. I mean, this is a phenomenal building, phenomenal event and game. And once kids from Canada have a chance, or elite players from the U.S. have a chance to see something like this, it usually sells them.
I just want to reintroduce Paul Kelly. He's the executive director of College Hockey Inc. Go ahead, Rich.
Sorry, Bill. I was going to say that a lot of people may not realize we've always heard so much about guys going to Canada to play junior hockey and play junior hockey in this country as well. But as of a year ago, 31% of NHL players had played NCAA hockey.
That's true. There's 720 players in the NHL, and last year, 294 of those players were alums of NCAA. That number is expected to go up. Within the next 5 years, we expect that 40% of all of the players in the National Hockey will have played Division I college hockey in the U.S. So it's a great place for players to develop, not only get an education, but develop as potential future professionals.
You know, as this goes along, Paul, it kind of becomes a double-edged sword because a lot of these kids are coming to college and staying for 1 year or maybe 2 years and then trying their hand at a pro career.
Well, that's an issue, too. You know, our coaches have the challenge of recruiting to get the guys into the school and then continuing to recruit them to keep them from leaving. I mean, particularly some elite programs, are losing kids after 1 or 2 years. We'd like to, raise the draft age in the National Hockey League by 1 year up to 19 and hopefully keep kids 1 extra year. We'd like to see kids stay in school at least 3 years, and always 4 is better.
How much cooperation do you get from the NHL on something like that?
You know, the NHL has been a great partner of ours. College Hockey Inc. is actually funded by the National mm-hmm. Hockey League. They want us to promote the sport in the country. They want college hockey to continue to develop in great players. So they're very responsive to any of the requests and some of the challenges that we have. And frankly, they've been great to work with so far.
Paul, in this market, and I'm someone that works in sports in this market, in the newscast, and how, you have these, the Yales and Quinnipiacs and Sacred Hearts. It's such a big basketball state, and certainly the UConn teams get most of the play. What types of things do you look to do in the future to get, people in news like myself to pay more attention to college hockey?
I think it's better television exposure, and we're starting to get that. Games like tonight broadcast in the northeast part of the country is a big plus. Getting NBC and CBS involved in that is helpful. Special events, developing new types of special events, and we're doing that with not only our championships but our icebreaker tournaments. I think it's catching on. I mean, we're developing great talent in places and parts of the country that we were never developing it before, whether it's Florida or California, down in Texas, and we'd like to see some more schools add the sport. It'd be nice to have some schools other than Alabama, Huntsville, down in the southeast, and frankly, we don't have anything west of Denver, so a little bit more work to do there.
Sure.
You mentioned that, and I was just going to ask you about, there are pockets, hockey pockets, throughout the United States where people just go crazy over the sport, no matter what level it's at. How do you spread the word to those other areas down south and out west that this is a pretty good game?
We travel, my colleagues and I from College Hockey Inc., we do travel. We visit San Jose and Phoenix and Vegas and Dallas, and we talk to families, and we get to see firsthand the level of play. And what you see happening is NHL players that played in those cities have stayed behind and now had their own families and stayed in coaching. And it's one of the principal reasons why you're seeing so many great young players being developed in these different parts of the country. Now we just need some colleges to add the sport in some of those same parts of the country to keep those kids here.
All right, Paul, I want to thank you so much. Paul Kelly, the executive director of College Hockey Inc., thanks for stopping by, and enjoy the rest of your evening here at the bank.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Okay. Thanks, Paul. Bobcats with a 3-1 lead over Harvard. We'll be right back.